Hello, and welcome to this ArcherPoint presentation on bills material. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at ArcherPoint. I'm going to be leading you through this today. The first thing I'd like to discuss is that there's two types of bills material in Business Central. The first is the production BOM. This is more for traditional manufacturing. This can be used in conjunction with a routing that actually keeps track of the steps and the traveler that goes to the machine centers. It has more complex costing, and it can also be used in conjunction with things like subcontractors. Then there's the assembly bill of material. This is a more simple idea of kitting or assembly that is something that two things can be put together, but they can also be undone. And you want to track the cost typically of a person who's doing that work, who's putting those things together and taking them apart. And so we're going to look at what those comparisons are. We're briefly going to look at routings, and we're just going to do a general overview of what those are and how they're set up. So let's go ahead and jump into the production BOM. And we're going to create a new one here. I'm going to just create an example item number. Now, with your number series, you can have this automated, but often we see companies are manually entering these because they want the production BOM number to be the same as the item number, so that users can easily distinguish that this production BOM number makes this item number. And by making those things the same, it's easier to keep track of. Go ahead and put in a description. Next, we have our unit of measure code. The unit of measure code is important to note that you must select a unit of measure that is also set up on the item that you're going to assign this to. So you can't have a unit of measure here that doesn't exist on the item that it's related to. Next, we'll look at our lines. We can select item or production BOM. Item means that this is exactly a standard use of what you would expect, that I'm going to consume one of these directly out of inventory, and that's going to be what's called when I plan my production order. If I select production BOM, what's going to happen here is it's not going to look for this item number in inventory. It's going to look for the components that are listed on this bill of material. So this is an easy way if you have a variety of sub-assemblies or sub-recipes, you can set one of those up and then continue to call that, and it will call all of the components without telling you that you need to make this and put it into inventory first before you consume it on this production order. There's a variety of additional things that you can get more complicated with here as far as how this is calculated, what the scrap percentage are, the routing link code, if this is tying the material to a specific step in the routing. That gets a little out of the scope of this more overview demonstration. So we'll skip that. But if you have questions about that, you can always follow up in the comments or by contacting us at ArcherPoint. When we're ready to finish this, we say that it's certified. Now let's hop over to our item and see how this is assigned. Now that I've created my production bill material, I'm going to go into my items to assign it. And I'm going to go into an item that doesn't have a production BOM number on it. And I'm also making sure to select an item that has a unit of measure that is equal to the unit of measure that was on my production BOM. It doesn't have to be the base unit of measure. It just has to be in the unit of measure table. So if you have pieces, box, pallet, and you can manufacture any level of those, it just somewhere in the item unit of measure table, you have to have the same code as what you put in the production BOM header. So I go down to replenishment, I go down to production BOM, and I see my example bill of material, and here's where I assign it. Now, when you go and create a production order, you select that you want to make this item. It's now going to pull from this production BOM number that we just set up. And once that's done, if later there's a change to what's happening here for which items you're using, or you have a part that's changed out or added, You can also use versions to manage additional versions and copies and track the changes of that over time. And the active version is what will always pull into that production order. So next, we're going to talk about the routing briefly. So the routing has a lot of areas that we could really dive deeply into, but again, this is a simple overview. You set up the operation numbers and then can have a number of work and machine centers with operations, lot sizes, and total time. And this is what helps the planning. When you create the production order, it gives an estimated time of how long it's going to take in order for your production order to be finished. And once this routing is set up, you go and assign that in the same place on the item card. And the combination of those two is how it knows what items it needs and then how long that's going to take. And again, you have to certify it so that it can be used and you can track active versions. And a little more deep down, you can use these work centers to create a variety of costs. And that gets into another layer of what's the total amount of cost for the total output that you created. So the combination of all of those things is what drives the end result of your production order. Now let's go ahead and look at the assembly. So here I can see in my list, do we have an assembly BOM? I'll just go to my golf cart. So here I can see that I have a list of items and I have descriptions under that. And I can also have sub-assemblies under there. So similar to how we could select a production BOM, we can have another kit that is here to be used on my assembly. And if I go and edit my list, we can see that besides an item, I can also add a resource. And this is how cost can be associated with how long it takes to assemble one of these units. So if we select Lena here, and say it's going to take her 1 hour to assemble this. Now I can go and look on Lena's resource card and see that there's a unit cost associated with her hourly rate. And that's how time and the amount of cost are associated on the assembly order. So you'll notice right away that this is a lot simpler of a layout, and you have a few additional options here, but in general, when you're creating an assembly order, it's going off of a simplified version of what would be a production. If you have any questions about what we've covered in the video today, please feel free to make a comment on the video or reach out to us directly. We can lead you through more differences between the bill of materials, what the best setup would be for your organization, and more of the in-depth ways that you can use both of these functionalities in Business Central. Thanks for your time.
Thank you for watching this Archer Point video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.